Adventurous kids explore with education and learning what a wild life is in the Everglades. I want to explore the Museum of Discovery and Science. What plants do butterflies like? I want to know about Key West. Adventurous kids learning and fun. Adventurous kids.
Going to tell you about computer viruses. Computer virus is a type of computer program that, when executed, replicates itself by modifying other computer programs and inserting its own code. When the replication succeeds, the affected areas are then said to be infected with a computer virus. In addition to copying itself, a computer virus can also execute instructions that cause harm. For this reason, computer viruses affect security. They are part of malware. Very often the term is also used for other kinds of malware, such as Trojan horses and worms. Even though this is wrong, it may be difficult to tell the difference between different kinds of malware. They often occur together, and only an expert may be able to tell them apart. Such programs also fit more than one category. Computer viruses are created for a cause. Sometimes they are created to spread political messages, and they are also created to hack some system files. Computer viruses are spread through many ways. Some of the types of spreading are email, removable hardware, downloading, and so on. There are different kinds of computer viruses. Probably the most common form is the macro virus or script virus. Such viruses are programmed with a script function, which is present in many text processing systems and spreadsheets, or with general script functionality of a program, boot sector. Viruses infect the boot sector of floppy disks, hard drives, and other media. Executable files and scripts of the operating system, including those that are run automatically when a medium is inserted into a drive, cross-site scripting. Scripts and web pages that replicate to other web pages, any computer file, generally buffers, overflows, format strings, and race conditions are exploitable. A viable computer virus must contain a search routine which locates new files or new disks which are worthwhile targets for infection. Secondly, every computer virus must contain a routine to copy itself into the program which the search routine locates. The main virus parts are infection mechanism, trigger, payload, and four phases. Once a virus has successfully attached to a program, file, or document, the virus will lie dormant until circumstances have caused the computer or device to execute its code. In order for a virus to infect your computer, you have to run the infected program, which in turn causes the virus code to be executed. This means that a virus can remain dormant on your computer without showing major signs or symptoms. However, once the virus infects your computer, the virus can infect other computers on the same network. Stealing passwords or data, logging keystrokes, corrupting files, spamming your email, contacts, and even taking over your machine are just some of the devastating and irritating things a virus can do. While some viruses can be playful in intent and effect, others can have profound and damaging effects. This includes erasing data or causing permanent damage to your hard disk. Worse yet, some viruses are designed with financial gains in mind. In a constantly connected world, you can contract a computer virus in many ways, some more obvious than others. Viruses can be spread through email and text message attachments, internet file downloads, and social media scam links. Your mobile devices and smartphones can become infected with mobile viruses through shady app downloads. Viruses can hide disguised as attachments of socially shareable content such as funny images, greeting cards, or audio and video files. To avoid contact with a virus, it's important to exercise caution when surfing the web, downloading files, and opening links or attachments. To help stay safe, never download text or email attachments that you're not expecting, or files from websites that you don't trust. A computer virus attack can produce a variety of symptoms. Here are some of them. Frequent pop-up windows. Pop-ups might encourage you to visit unusual sites, or they might prod you to download antivirus or other software programs. Changes to your homepage. Your usual homepage may change to another website, for instance. Plus, you may be unable to reset it. Mass emails being sent from your email account. A criminal may take control of your account or send emails in your name from other affected computer. Frequent crashes. A virus can inflict major damage on your hard drive. This may cause your device to freeze or crash. It may also prevent your device from coming back on. Unusually slow computer performance. A sudden change of processing speed could signal that your computer has a virus. Unknown programs that start up when you turn on your computer. You may become aware of the unfamiliar program when you start your computer. Or you might notice it by checking your computer's list of active applications. Unusual activities like password changes. This could prevent you from logging into your computer. How can you help protect your devices against computer viruses? Here are some of the things you can do to help keep your computer safe. Use a trusted antivirus product such as Norton Antivirus Basic, and keep it updated with the latest virus definitions. Norton Security Premium offers additional protection for even more devices, plus backup. Avoid clicking on any pop-up advertisements. Always scan your email attachments before opening them. Always scan the files that you download using file sharing programs. Thanks for watching this Adventures Kids episode.
What did you learn today?
Adventurous kids!
Adventurous kids!
What was the most interesting fact?
Adventurous kids!
Adventurous kids!
Adventurous!